So, is there anybody right now? Is there anybody that's got any kind of pain in their body right now? Anybody? Yeah, you? Okay, come on, come on. Okay, let's, you can come up as well. Hallelujah. What kind of pain? What's going on? Bone disease. Does it hurt just now? Pain? Like, okay. So now, we're going to do practical, right? So, this is the benefit of actually teaching, because we want to show you how to pray for the sick. Okay? Okay. So, let's say you're on the street, right? So, what's her name here?
Annette.
Annette. Good. Do you understand what I mean? I ask for her name. Always ask, speak like, let's say you walk up this one. Let's say I walked up, I'm walking on the, and I just met Annette, she's sitting on the chair or something like that. And then I'm like, hello, Annette. What's your name? Annette. Okay. So, the next thing I want to do, introduce yourself. Smile. Courteous. Be courteous. Be courteous, smile. And, okay, Annette. So, next I'm going to try and ask what the level of pain is. Okay. So, Annette, on a scale of 0, meaning no pain, and 10 is like excruciating pain, what's the level of pain?
7.
Like a 7. So, 7 over 10, that's quite high, right? Okay. So, why am I asking that? I want to ask that because when we pray, sometimes it doesn't go instantly. Like, it doesn't go from 7 to 0 instantly. Sometimes the Bible says they began to amend. So sometimes I go from a 7 to a 3 to a 2 to a 1 to a 0. So sometimes it goes down. So when we pray the first time, or we pray, sometimes we go, okay, that's great, but sometimes it begins to reduce. The reason why you want to do that is because when it begins to move, you want to be thanking God, like, God, thank you, that's moved from a 7 to whatever. And they say, Lord, we want more. Because my goal in my heart is to go to 0. I don't want her to be in pain. I don't want Annette, right?
Yeah.
I don't want Annette to be in pain. I want to see her heal. So, the next thing we do, we're going to speak. I'm going to pray, but I'm just trying to explain what we're going to do first. So, we're going to speak to the pain and to the gums, right? We're going to command the pain to go, and obviously the gum to be healed, right? And then we trust the Holy Spirit to do it. Amen. It's not magic. It's just the Holy Spirit. So you don't have to. I'll do the laying on of hands part because then it's easy. I'll tell you the story behind that. I was so used to laying hands on people. At one point, Holy Spirit said, "Don't touch them anymore," because my faith was based on I must touch the person to be healed. And guess what's going to happen? The devil's going to make sure you can't touch them, and because I can't touch them, then my faith will not be activated. Then I'm not going to see them healed. So at one point, Holy Spirit told me, "Say no, you are getting to you're trusting too much in touching. I don't want to just touch it, but just speak." And then I had to just then I started, you know, just sort of command, and then it'll happen. But anyway, that's just a different story. I just want to let you know you can either, because some people don't like you to touch them, and this is why you need to understand how to flow with the Spirit. You know, because sometimes you may not have the opportunity to touch the person. I was like, no, don't touch them. Okay. So then what do? You get stuck. You can't touch them, but then you can speak. I'm like, okay. Command the pain to go. So anyway, in this case, I'm going to lay hands on her. I'm going to ask her, is it okay if I put my hands on you?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. You can touch a person anyway. Now let me say this about touching. This is very important. Very, very important, right? Now, she's a lady, right? There are some times when a lady may have a problem in the part of her body that is inappropriate to touch the person there. Okay? You need to understand that God is not limited. He's unlimited. So, sometimes in my own, if it's an example, let's say it's a lady's stomach, right? I wouldn't want to put my hand on the lady's stomach. I'll tell the lady, you put your hand on your stomach, and I'm going to put my hand on her hand, okay? If it's in a part of her body that is very inappropriate to touch, I'll just put my hand on her shoulder, because you don't need to, God can do it. It doesn't matter to God. You know, but the key is point of contact anyway, so it doesn't matter. Anyway, so that's about touching. So usually, if we're in a team, for example, like we'll be in a team tomorrow, if it's a lady, it's usually easier or better for ladies to pray for ladies and men to pray for men. Because at the end of the day, you have to just kind of use a bit more common sense. Because in the real life situation, you know, some people may feel funny. You know, some people don't like touching, or they'll prefer, or they'll be more comfortable if it's a lady touching them or putting a hand on them, or if it's a man putting a hand on a man or whatever. So it's just kind of just, these are kind of like the basics of ministry where we're trying to just be using common sense to do stuff. But anyway, in this case, I'm just going to put my hand on her shoulder or something like that. I can put a man on my hand. Which part of the?
It's at the top.
At the top, yeah, okay. I'll just put my hand there because it's not too bad. So, then I'll just speak to the pain. Pain, you go right now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I command you gums and jaw be healed right now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. The Holy Spirit is in you, and just trust the Holy Spirit to move and just touch your lips and touch your mouth right now in Jesus' name. I can just put my hand for like 5 seconds, doesn't matter how long, but I just trust Holy Spirit to do it. Thank you, Lord. Okay, how does it feel? It's probably 7, is it still there?
I'm trying to poke it like so hard.
Yeah, poke it hard, poke it as hard as you want to poke it.
Yeah, so it's not 7.
Poke it real as hard as you want.
Never poked it like this before.
Poke it really hard. Poke it as hard as you want.
I'm trying to look for pain.
I'm trying to look for it. Can you feel it?
No.
You can't feel it?
No, I can't feel pain.
Come on. That's Holy Spirit. Come on. Poke it really hard.
No, but I wouldn't even touch here.
Wow.
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank Jesus. So I want you to pray for her. Just thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord, for the healing. And I just pray for her gone to totally heal. And the pain is gone. God has healed her. But I just want to pray for total restoration of her gums. And every gum disease to be gone right now in Jesus' name. Father, thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. All right, good. Thank you. You're welcome. But yeah, so thank Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Sometimes when you pray for people, they all want to start thanking you. But this is very, I want to say something that's very, very important. If you don't remember anything, remember this. Always, always give the glory to God. It's not your glory to keep. Amen. Always, glory goes back to Him. I'll tell you how I learned about, I had an encounter one time, I keep talking about, I have a super spiritual encounter, but I had an encounter where Jesus spoke to me and said, very clearly, never touch the glory. The glory because it belongs to Him. So, if healing happens, always give the glory back to Him. Amen. It belongs to Him. Anyway, so, what's happened?
I've got pain in my back. It's just about
Like the shoulder blade there.
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's been there about 3 days only.
Amen. Okay.
It hurts.
It hurts right
I would
now.
Say about 6.
About 6 out of 10. 10. Okay. Does anyone want to... I can do it, but I want someone else to do it. So you know, who wants to go for it? Anybody? Don't be shy. We just taught you how to heal the sick. Come on. Remember, it's not you. You're not supposed to remember that. Just put it back. It's not me. It's the Holy Spirit. Okay? The Holy Spirit does it. So you speak. Okay. Can you just speak to the pain? You just command the pain to go and just say, shoulder healed in Jesus' name. Yeah.
Shoulder commands to be healed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Pain go, be gone, and full restoration.
Amen. Thank you. Move it around. Feel it. How does
still
it feel?
Tingling.
How does it feel? Like from a 6, what do you think?
It's down, definitely. About, I would say 3.
3, okay. So,
yay, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes. So, it's tingling at the moment.
Yes.
Awesome. So, that's Holy Spirit. When you say tingling, Holy Spirit doing something. So, we'll come out again. Speak again. So, just speak to it again. Same thing.
Shoulder be healed, pain be gone.
Right now.
Right now. Right
Amen.
Now. Thank you. Right now. Down to 0. Thank you for the 0.
All right, moving around.
It's about 1.
About 1? Go again. We're going for 100%. Father, thank you. 100%. Lord, we're going for. Come on. Come on. 100%. Go again. One more.
Thank you, Lord, for 100%.
Thank you, Lord.
It's about 0.5.
100%. We're going for everything. Come on, 100. Nothing. We don't anything there.
Very little.
There you go. 100.
100%. Jesus' name. Of course, this. Stop this.
It's
not funny. Jesus' name.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Can't feel it. Come on. Give God the glory. Come on. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. That's amazing. Hallelujah. Come on. Amen.
It's good to go out tomorrow.
Hallelujah. Come on. This is practical stuff, man. You know, this is why, like, come on. This is easy. This is easy. This is the Holy Spirit. This is awesome, man. Amen. Thank you. Thank you for coming out. Thank you for standing. stepping up. Awesome. Wow, good stuff. I'm pumped, like I'm ready to go. I'm ready to go on tomorrow. But yes. Sorry.
When you asked if anybody had pain,
yes.
I wanted to get up because I had pain in my foot. Right? And while that was going on, the pain in my foot went.
Come on!
No!
Jesus!
In fact, I began to, because actually I've been slightly worried and thinking, I remember I went on a cruise, how many years ago? About 3 years ago, and they told me, oh, you have the beginning of plantar fasciitis. And then, they sold me this heel things, cushions. I've lost them. I was fine. And then recently, I've been having
pain again.
Especially on my left leg, and I'm thinking, what is this, Lord? And now, I wanted to get to a point, you said, does anybody have pain? But it's gone.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Isn't God awesome? Like, we're praying for one, and that's why you know it's the Holy Spirit. That's why you know it's God. Because we weren't praying for her, but the Holy Spirit just moves, you know? This is amazing. I love him so much. He's amazing. Hallelujah. Bless God. This is awesome. So that's how it's done. This is how it's done. It's so easy. How many of you believe it's easy?
Yeah.
Amen? How many of you think you can do it tomorrow? How many of you think, no, seriously, believe. You can. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Is there anyone else has any pain again? Anyone? Anyone else? You got pain? Come on. You got pain? Come on. What I'm trying to say, let's practice, because it's good to practice. Yeah, go. Yes. What's the, any pain? Whatever. You come. Anyway, it's okay. Waist? Okay. Feel a bit of pain? Like, okay, so. I can do it, but I want someone else to practice. Who wants to practice? You want to go? Come on then, come on. Awesome. So, no more questions? On a scale of 0 to 10, what's the level of pain and all that kind of stuff?
Say about 4.
Okay.
Good. And since it's a man-to-man, so it's fine. So just lay your hands on the thing and just command it to go.
All pain leave in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Go in Jesus' name.
Amen. Okay, move it around. Feel it. Is pain gone? Is it dead?
It's like the moment.
It's numb. Yeah. As Holy Ghost anesthetic. Wow. It's numb.
Yeah.
Do you feel any pain?
No.
Wow.
When I came here sitting down there earlier, I was
feeling. You're feeling it now?
It's right now, I just can feel it like. As the pastor is telling me, but I can still like twitching.
It feels like tingling. You see, this is how you know it's Holy Spirit, because there are various, I'll just explain it. Holy Spirit, he manifests in different ways. Sometimes it's like a numbness, sometimes it's like a tingling, sometimes like heat, you know, sometimes like ice cold, like a numb ice cold. When I hear that, I just know Holy Spirit is doing something. You know, that's how you know, you pick this up, when you're praying for the sick, usually ask them what's happening. Because that's the key, you then know, okay, Holy Spirit is actually doing something. When I hear numbness, tingling, heat, all that kind of stuff, those are kind of different manifestations of the Holy Spirit. So the pain, is it any pain at all?
No, no pain.
Thank you, Jesus, come on, give him the glory. Hallelujah, awesome, thank you, brother. Thank you so much, awesome. Thank you so much, man. Okay, so tell us what's happening.
I've got back pain.
Back pain.
Back posture work.
Okay, so who wants to go for it? Who wants to go for it? So come on, volunteer. It's easy. You don't need to be scared. Holy, like you've seen us. I need a volunteer. Somebody come and do it. Come and pray for it and get it healed. Come on. Remember, it's the Holy Spirit doing it, not you. So you don't need to be worried. Okay. Right, okay, now I'm going to say this now. This is a typical example of when a guy's praying for a lady and it's on her waist. Guys, I wouldn't recommend you putting your hand on someone's waist, okay? That would be very inappropriate. So, put it on her shoulder. Oh, cool. Then, just go for a normal waist. Level of pain.
Back, right? All the way up the back.
Okay. Cool.
It's about 6.
About 6, okay. So about 6 over 10 of my pain, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
back. Or pain in the back, and I just believe, you know, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Pain, I mean, I'm just subsiding in Jesus' name completely. Amen.
All right, check it out.
It's an eight.
Heat. Okay, so now she's getting the heat in her back. Holy Spirit is doing something. Amen. It's gone. Is it? Bend it around, move it around.
Oh, wait.
You can feel it. You can feel it. Okay, that's cool. So it's 6 to 2. Okay, that's fine. Pray again. What? Can you feel it?
I think I'm good.
Hallelujah! Come on! You're not excited! This is the Holy Spirit! Come on! Guys! This is God! Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus! Come on! Tell us what's happening.
I woke up this morning with fever, serious fever, and like the right side of my body, serious pains.
Well, pains, okay?
Yeah, I will take one. And then I text them, you know, I'm like, I'm having fever, please pray for me. And then, because I was already in tears on my bed. And then she prayed for me, I was able to get up and my back come. But I still feel pain in my back and my right leg, and I still feel fever.
Okay, cool. All right, who wants to go for it? Who wants to pray for her? Somebody, volunteer, come on. This is practice. You see, you don't need to be afraid or worried, whatever. It's not about you. One of the things you're gonna have to learn about the healing ministry is, it has nothing to do with you, you know? It's all about the Holy Spirit, and it's Him that does the work. So you don't need to be afraid, okay? Because He will do the work. He will back you up. So who's going to go for it? Don't be afraid. Don't be shy. You. Come on. Come on. Come on. I want to shine. Yes, come on. Come. Like I said, it's not about you. It's about the Holy Spirit. So He's going to do the work. All you need to do, like we said before, so she's got pain on the right side of her body. So you simply just command, speak to the pain, command it, say pain, go, fever, go, in Jesus' name, and just trust that the Holy Spirit is on the inside of you, right? And just trust Him, He'll do it, okay? Go for it.
In Jesus' name, pain, go, fever, go, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Okay, so on a scale of 0, like, what's the level of pain? What do you think? Okay, so what do you think it is right now?
Like a 5.5.
5, okay. All right, pray again.
In Jesus' name, fever go, pain go.
Amen.
Okay.
What do you think?
Still. Okay. I'm feeling like 2 hits.
Okay.
Like a
3.5. Come on. It's going down, so it's going in the right direction. Okay. Pray again. Jesus prayed twice, remember? For a guy who was blind, right? And Jesus prayed. So if Jesus could pray twice, I've got at least 10 shots. Right? So it's okay to pray again. It's okay. Come on. Go for it.
In Jesus' name, pain go. Command to go in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Two.
Go for it again. Pray again.
In Jesus' name, pain go. Command it to go.
Amen. Come on. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
It's not there.
Yeah. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Seriously. Yeah. Come on.
It's not there.
Come on. Awesome. Give Him the glory, guys. The reason why I'm doing this, so you realize I'm not a superstar. You guys are all the superstars, amen. Because you guys have got all the Holy Spirit inside of you. So you can do this on the street, you can do it anywhere. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. So that's all. That's all it is, to be honest with you. So that's about praying for the sick, right? So how many of us people can actually go out and pray for the sick tomorrow? Amen. Come on. The shyest person in the room actually healed someone. So, and if she could do it, we could all do it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for that. That's really awesome. You know, he's my best friend, and he's just too good. He makes me look good, but exactly him, actually. And he makes us all look good, because he's just too much. He's just so awesome. So, the next thing I want to talk about is prophetic evangelism. So what we've just done, you know, let's say I'm praying, like, let's demonstrate this. Let's find someone. Who wants to give it practice? Let's get someone. I'll pick on someone to practice. Okay? My sister. Oh, no, I'm going to pick on her. Come on. The hat. Yes, come on. Yeah? Okay. So, let's do a practical, right? I want to give her a prophetic word, right? And I'm just going to trust Holy Spirit. Because Holy Spirit knows her more than I do. Okay? And guess what? I have all the gifts of the Spirit in me. So I have the gift of prophecy in me, right? I can function in the prophetic anytime by faith. Amen. So I'm just going to ask Holy Spirit to just speak to her and give her words. And just speak to her. Father, thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I see a picture of a table. And I feel like you're studying at the moment. Are you? You get that? That was simple. I just saw a picture in my mind's eye of a table, and I know she's studying something. An exam just now? Amen. So, that's God speaking to her about an exam. And I feel like there's something regarding one of the papers you want to write, and you're a bit worried and troubled about it. But I feel like, guess what? This is the language that I feel like. I'm not saying thus says the Lord. Because I'm trying to give myself permission to miss it. In case I miss it, then God is not going to take the blame for my mistake. Amen. So I feel like God is trying to say to you that you shouldn't worry about this, that he's got your back, and that you already have a retentive memory. And I feel like you're just saying chapter 6 and 7. I don't know what chapter 6 and 7 means, but I feel like saying concentrate on chapter 6 and 7. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. I don't even know what chapter 6 and 7 means. But Holy Spirit does. Hallelujah. Glory. How awesome was that? That's amazing. Thank you, Holy Spirit. That's awesome. Glory. Glory. That's simple. I started from a table. And this is, the Bible says, we prophesy in part. We know in part, right? So, the first thing that's why when you step out in faith that way, you're just trusting Holy Spirit. I didn't know what it was, but I just trusted Holy Spirit. I said, Holy Spirit, give me a word. And the first thing he showed me was a table. Okay, I'm thinking in my head, okay, table, what does that mean? Okay, table, she studies. Okay, she's studying for an exam. I could hear how I was trying to, it's a revelation, I was progressing. And I was like, okay, studying for an exam, I'm a bit worried about something, chapter 6 and 7. And then God spoke to her through that. Hallelujah. That's exactly how you do the prophetic. It's not magic, it's Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. And you can do this any day, anytime. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Does anyone have any pain in their left ankle, anything, left knee or anything like that? Or somebody with a recurring pain, a left knee pain comes and goes? Yeah?
I got this. Yeah.
Do you usually have left knee pain? Yeah. Come on. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. What just happened to me right now is a word of knowledge. Do you get? So I'm trying to explain what just happened. Thank you, ma'am. Bless you, ma'am. So I had a word of knowledge. I just had a sharp pain in my left knee, and I knew something had to do with somebody's knees. Amen. So that's, I'm just trying to teach you how to flow the gifts of the Spirit. So that was a word of knowledge I just had, and Mama had the pain. So Mama, which knee is it actually troubling you?
This
one. Okay. So Heavenly Father, is it hurting? Is pain there now? Is it there? Just now. Okay. So Father, in Jesus' name, thank you for healing. Right now, I command all pain in that knee go in Jesus' name. I command the cartilage, I command the bone, the muscle, and the tendons, everything that need right now be healed and made whole in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Okay, Mama, just move it around. Move the knee. How does it feel? Is there any pain?
Little pain.
Is it a little more? Father, thank you for healing and wholeness. I just pray 100%, Lord, in Jesus' name, right now. 100%. All pain, go, right now. Knees be healed, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Move it around. How does it feel?
It's fine.
It's gone. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, give him glory. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you very much. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. So that's how we minister. That's why you need to be. I didn't teach this, but I think I should. About the gift of the word of knowledge, because in light of testimonies, who was healed yesterday? Who was healed yesterday? Amen. One, two, three. Who else? Who else was here? Was healed yesterday? Four. Mom was healed again. Five. Is it okay if we share your testimonies? Is that okay? Yeah? So guys, come on, share your testimonies. It's part of our weapon of warfare. So I want us to share testimonies of what God has done.
Awesome. Hi everyone. I had a shoulder pain. It was about 7 out of 10. It's not anymore.
Come on. Come on, Jesus.
Praise God.
Give him glory. Come on. Thank you. Come on. Give him glory.
Started off at like a 6 or 7, and then it went down to a 2. And before Daddy even got a chance to pray again, it was just gone.
Come on, give him glory! Come on, give him glory! No, guys, wait. We're gonna pray for you. Just stay. Because you know what? I wanna pray for you, so that you know. Bible says, "Freely we receive, right? Freely we give." So what you've received, you're gonna give it out to someone else.
Yeah.
So we're gonna pray for you. Hallelujah. Come on.
Praise the Lord. I came in yesterday with severe body pains and fever. I woke up with it, and then it was Laura that prayed for me.
Laura that prayed for me, also.
Yes. And the fever left. And
come on, Jesus! Come on. Come on.
Yes.
Come on.
Having a pain in my right side, waist, lower back. But when the.
I think it was him. Okay, yeah. Also.
When he prayed for me yesterday, so I feel total pain free yesterday.
Yeah. Awesome. Praise the Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Give him glory.
Bless you.
Yes,
you.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Will you allow me to say one thank you to Jesus?
Go on.
I am good. You see this leg? For long ago.
How many years?
Many years. This thing has been troubling me. Here. Down here. I don't sleep in the night. Yesterday, that through you, the Lord prayed for me.
Amen.
And healed me.
Amen.
No more pain.
Amen.
Come on! Father, we thank you. Lord, we thank you.
Yes.
Lord, we thank you.
Thank you.
All the glory, all the praise, all the honor, all adoration goes back to you, God, for your mercy, for your grace, for your power, for your love, your kindness, and your goodness. Father, we bless them, Lord. We bless them, Father. And we pray more, Lord. Lord, just release that which you've already given to them, Father, Lord, as they step out in faith, Lord. That which they freely receive, Father, they will freely give as well. Lord, that you will just anoint them afresh, Father God, with a fresh fire, Lord, a fresh fire, Lord, in Jesus' name, Lord. Let the fire of God, let the anointing of God's Spirit, Lord, come mightily upon them, Lord, in Jesus' name, Father God. That you would use them, Lord, to heal the sick, Lord, to cast out devils, to raise the dead, Father.
Yes, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, yes, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We bless and love you, Father. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Give him glory. Give him glory. Hallelujah. Isn't that awesome?
Awesome.
Come on.
Yeah.
Who's excited? Whoa. Come on.
Jesus.
Who's excited? And do you know what? Guess who prayed for them? Everybody did. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It was the body.
Yeah.
Amen. That was 100%. Hey. Right? 100% result. Every single one was healed.
Wow.
Every single person that we prayed for yesterday got healed. And that was because the body prayed.
Mm.
I'll say that again. It wasn't about me. It was about the body prayed. Every one of us prayed. Every one of us trusted. Every one of us had faith and we went for it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory. Just before we go, is there anybody here that's got any pain? Anybody sick, pain, anything? You got some?
I got prayed before, but my toothache increased. I didn't sleep the whole night. It just got worse, but you know, can we?
Awesome, let's pray for it. Come on. Let's pray for it, Father, in Jesus' name. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. So like on a scale, so this is practical, right? So on a scale of zero.
12.
So it really hurts.
It really hurts.
What's your name here?
Tom.
Father, in Jesus' name, right now, I pray for Tom. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Ember, just stretch out your hand. Let's pray for him. Jesus. Right now, I command a pain in a tooth.
It's a broken tooth. You should restore it.
Amen. Right now, Lord, I command pain. Go! In Jesus' name, right now. Infirmity. Go! In Jesus' name. Tooth, be healed. I made whole. Now, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I command right now that tooth be healed. All pain, go. Thank you, Lord. How does it feel?
Eight.
Can eight? Okay.
Eight.
Pray again, right? Holy Spirit, I thank you for what you're doing. Thank you for what you're doing, Lord. And I just pray more, Lord. All pain, go right now. Infirmity, go in Jesus' name. Right now, tooth, be healed and made whole. Now, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, right now. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Better.
Amen. 100%? Like anything?
No, still a 5.
Like a 5?
Still a 5.
More,
yeah.
More, Lord. Thank you for what you're doing. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for what you're doing, Holy Spirit. Say more. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for what you're already doing. Just say more. Lord, I want to go 100% more. Jesus. Lord, you love Tom so much. You don't want him to be in pain. And I thank you because you're already taking away this pain right now, Lord. Thank you. More. 100% more. We're going for 100%. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Whoa, cool, shoot. This guy's really soaking it.
It's much better. He's nearly gone, mate.
What do you think, like, what do you think?
Two.
Two? Okay, yeah, more, Jesus. More. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Wow.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Wow.
Whoa, thank you. We just received. We receive, Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. More, Lord. 100% Holy Spirit. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. How does it feel?
It's good.
Like, any more pain?
No.
No pain?
No pain.
Jesus! Come on! Come on! No pain. No pain.
Hallelujah!
Come on.
Hallelujah!
Amen! Maybe to say one thing. Go on. Maybe to say one thing. I was hoping that you were asking for prayer.
Wow.
You know, because I said, either I have the choice now to take a paracetamol or I get prayer. And I said, Lord, I'm not taking a paracetamol.
Amen.
I want prayer, but I want you to do that. So thank you, Jesus. Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Wow. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you. That's awesome, man. Thank you. So that's it, you know?
Just
got a shoulder.
Shoulder, okay, cool. Yeah. So, on the back. Okay, awesome. Okay, so I can do it, but I want somebody else to practice, okay? Who wants to do it? You want to go? Come on, come on, do it.
Okay, let's do it.
Come on.
Yes.
Go for it, man.
Yes,
so, you just ask him the level of pain, like?
Just
about five. About five, over ten, okay? Cool.
The shoulder, the heel, right now, Jesus.
Amen. Move it around, check it out. Move it. Like, is this still to five, or is it gone? Is it reduced, or how do you think?
Just comes and goes. So
okay, so is it like there just now again? Like from the five, is it still there?
Still.
Okay,
yes.
Go for it again.
Amen. All the pain, go ahead.
Just speak to the bone, the tendon, the muscles.
Muscles, we feel it right now. Jesus, go ahead. Go ahead.
Move it around, check it out.
It's dropped a slot.
Dropped? Okay, go again. Shoot it again.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Jesus, thank you, Lord.
From like a three, where do you think now? Two, go again, hit again, hit again.
Jesus.
More, more. Thank you, Holy Spirit. More. Thank you, Holy Spirit. More, Lord.
You to come to Jesus right now in Jesus' name. I command all the men to go right now for Jesus' name.
Amen. Come on. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Come on.
Drop in.
Drop in, okay? So what do you drop think now? Like one. Go on then. More. 100%. I like to go for 100%. Like, come on. I want to go for 100%. Thank you, Lord. Very very energetic, but go for it. 100%, 100%. 100%, Lord. More Lord.
So that's like 0.5.
0.5, come on, 1.5, get everything, want all everything to go, more, Holy Spirit, more Lord, come on, more Lord. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. More Lord.
100% Holy Spirit. 100% heals right now. Jesus' name. Command all the pain. Go right now. Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
This thing in
thank
place.
You, Lord. Come on. Heal?
Yeah.
Good.
Very good.
Good. Come on. Give him glory. 100%. He's so specific, like 0.2.
If you're gonna get it, you've got to get it 100%. So.
Get everything. 0.2.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord.
Jesus.
Amen. Thank you, Holy
Spirit. Go. Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Yes. I think it's still 0.2, but the sense is going down. Yeah, it's going down. Thank you.
100%.
Thank you.
The muscle,
the
bone is
tightness right now. It's loosened up right now.
Thank you.
Thank you.
What about the back?
Yeah.
Just,
yeah,
the,
no, 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 no,
pain
on the back.
What about the legs? There's no pain on the back.
No?
Thank you.
Yeah.
So how about tightness? Loose. Is it loosening?
Yeah.
Loose? Can you feel anything? Okay.
Jesus. Check the length.
Yeah. Go for it.
What I want for the Lord, I want it 100%.
Check the length. Are they same length?
Yeah. Check. Okay. Let's check the arm. Let's
roll them out.
Let's check the arm. No, put your arms out like this.
Yeah.
It's pretty straight. So
yeah, it is.
Pretty good.
It's
arms.
Yeah. It's just I think I slept on.
I slept on and.
Yeah, I just slept on it.
Okay.
I cannot go over as well. So.
But how does it feel? Is it 100%? Is it like 0.2,
0.1?
0.2, 0.1. But yeah, but I noticed that like, you just dropping. So I think the Lord will continue.
Definitely. Because sometimes not always a miracle instantly. Yes. Sometimes it's a progressive.
Exactly.
It began to get better. At least we've already gone from a 5.
Because I've been praying about it, it goes, then I overwork it again, and then it comes back. Then I pray about it again, it goes, and then it comes back again. So I just felt okay. But this time around, I think it's dropping again.
Thank you, Lord. I thank you. We've gone to 0.1.
Yeah.
Father, we'll just say, Lord, just
notice that.
Yeah, we'll check his arms.
The way you do it normally is, so you do,
okay,
like, close your eyes and then do that, because else you bring them together.
Yeah.
Yeah, there is a difference.
Can you do that?
Can you do it one more? Just keep it like that. Don't bring them together. So just do this, don't bring them together. Left, come out in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Come out all the way.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus. Yeah. It's moving in.
Yeah.
The body right is moving.
Yeah,
right. I told the left to move.
Because the right is the one.
Yeah, I know, but really? One first and then the other.
He's speaking to one hand, the other hand is moving.
You have to be clear.
Yeah. Equal in the end.
Yeah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Come on.
Come on.
Right, come out in the name of Jesus. All the way. All the way. All the way.
Yeah, you can see.
Every body part healed in the name of Jesus right now. Amen. And now be equal. Left be equal to the right in the name of Jesus.
Can feel it.
It's
gone now.
It's gone now.
Thank you.
Jesus. Thank you.
Come on.
Come on.
Jesus. Come on.
Hey.
It's gone.
Now. It's gone.
Gone.
We just forgot to adjust the arm. Amen.
Amen.
Amazing. Come on. Thank you, Holy Spirit. That's amazing. That's really good. Thank you, brother. Bless you. Thank you. Awesome.